This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, in the previous session of electrochemistry, I talked about specific conductance. K. I defined this K as G into C, where G was cell constant, and the C was conductance, of the electrolytic material. This I consider as electrolytic cell. This will be the length where we have filled the electrolytic material. This is the cross-sectional area. Okay, and the unit of K, cell constant unit will be, because cell constant is L by A. So if I say L as centimeter, A will be centimeter square. So centimeter inverse will be the unit of this cell constant. And conductance unit is ohm inverse, or we say mho, or we say in SI unit, Simon. Okay, so the unit of this K will be, ohm inverse, centimeter inverse, or we say ohm inverse, meter inverse, or we say Simon meter inverse. My point is clear. Now, dear students, to compare, if we want to compare the conductance of two electrolytic solutions, then specific conductance is not the suitable quantity, because different electrolytic solutions may have different concentrations, and when they have different concentrations, number of ions will be different. If number of ions different, then conductance will change. So it is necessary to define physically more meaningful quantities to compare the conductances of different electrolytic solutions, and these are molar conductance and equivalent conductance. So in this session we will talk about molar conductance and equivalent conductance. First I will talk about molar conductance. Molar conductance is also written as molar conductivity, and it is represented with lambda m like this. Molar conductance is defined as the conductance of a volume of solution containing one mole of dissolved electrolyte when placed between two parallel electrodes 1 centimeter apart and large enough to contain between them all the solution. In short, the meaning of this molar conductance is the conductance of one mole electrolyte. Recall molar mass, of 1 mole. Recall molar volume, of 1 mole. So molar conductance is conductance of 1 mole electrolyte. Now consider a solution, electrolytic solution whose molarity is given as capital M. So what is the definition of molarity? Molarity is number of moles of solute. Solute means electrolyte here. Number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of the electrolytic solution. So mathematically I can write m moles of electrolyte present in how much volume? 1000 ml volume. Okay, so 1 mole will be present in how much volume? 1000 upon m ml volume. And please note, 1 ml and 1 cc centimeter cube both are same. So instead of writing ml, I can write this as 1000 by m centimeter cube or cc. Dear students, conductance here we have said, molar conductance, we have said conductance of 1 mole. And 1 mole electrolyte, 1 mole electrolyte means how much volume? 1000 by m centimeter cube electrolytic solution. So molar conductivity, either you say conductance of 1 mole electrolyte or you say conductance of this much of volume. So molar conductance or molar conductivity can also be defined as the conductance of 1000 by m centimeter cube volume. And recall the previous session, there I defined K specific conductance as the conductance of how much material? Conductance of 1 centimeter cube material I defined as K. So if the conductance of 1 centimeter cube material is K, what will be the conductance of 1000 by m centimeter cube material? Conductance of 1000 by m centimeter cube material will be K times 1000 by m, and this is our molar conductance lambda m. So finally, what formula we can write here? Lambda m is equal to 1000 K by m. This is the formula. Units are very, very important. Please note, when you use this formula, we have taken volume as centimeter cube. So the unit of this K, the unit of K must be ohm inverse centimeter inverse. And this molarity we have taken in moles per liter. That is why we have said 1000 ml. Okay. So this molarity must be in moles per liter when you use this formula 1000 K by m. So when K will be in ohm inverse centimeter inverse and m in moles per liter, the unit of this lambda m will come as ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. Because when you multiply 1000, the liter will become ml, means centimeter cube. So this will go in the numerator where centimeter inverse will be multiplied, and this way we get centimeter square. And because it was mole per liter, so in the numerator we will have mole inverse. My point is clear. So unit of lambda m will be ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. This is the molar conductance or molar conductivity, and this is the relation between molar conductivity and specific conductivity. My point is clear. Now I will take a question here. Here the question says, what is the molar conductivity of 0.8 m electrolytic solution whose resistivity is 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 ohm centimeter? We have to find molar conductivity, means lambda m, and what is given? Specific resistance or resistivity. So rho is given. How much? 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 ohm centimeter. Please take care of the unit. Since rho is known, we can easily find K because it is reciprocal of rho. So it will be 1 upon 5 into 10 raised to minus 3, and that is how much? 200. ओम इनवर्स सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. सिंस के इज 200, सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस के इन द फॉर्मूला लैम्डा एम इज इक्वल टू 1000 के बाय एम. के इज फाउंड हियर, एम इज गिवन हियर एंड इफ यू सॉल्व द वैल्यू कम्स एज 2.5 इंटू 10 रेज टू 5. मोलैरिटी वी हैव टू कीप इन मोल्स पर लीटर, के वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर इन ओम इनवर्स सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. फॉर्चुनेटली इट इज गिवन इन ओम इनवर्स सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स एंड दिस वे द यूनिट ऑफ लैम्डा एम विल कम एज ओम इनवर्स सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर मोल इनवर्स. My point is clear. So 2.5 into 10 raised to 5. This matches with the option C. So for this particular question, the option C is the correct answer. My point is clear. Now I will talk about equivalent conductance. Equivalent conductance or equivalent conductivity. This is represented with the lambda EQ. It can be defined as the conductance of a volume of solution containing 1 gram equivalent of dissolved electrolyte when placed between two parallel electrodes 1 centimeter apart and large enough to contain between them all the solution. In short, equivalent conductance is actually conductance of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte. As we said, in case of molar conductance of 1 mole, here equivalent conductance means conductance of 1 gram equivalent. Gram equivalent is also written as equivalent. So 1 equivalent electrolyte. Conductance of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte. Now consider a solution whose concentration is given as normality. So normality of this solution is N. Now what is the definition of normality? It is the number of gram equivalents of solute means electrolyte, present in how much solution? 1000 ml. So I can write mathematically N gram equivalents of electrolyte are related with how much of volume? 1000 ml. 1000 ml can also be written as 1000 cc means centimeter cube, because 1 ml and 1 cc both are same. So 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte will be related with how much volume? 1000 by n cc. So either you say equivalent conductance as the conductance of 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte, or you say conductance of 1000 by n centimeter cube, both will be same. Now we know the relation of volume with conductance, kappa K, specific conductance. It is the conductance of 1 centimeter cube electrolyte. So if 1 centimeter electrolyte conductance is K, then what will be the conductance of 1000 by n centimeter cube? It will be 1000 by n into K. My point is clear. 1 centimeter cube electrolytic solution conductance is K. So 1000 by n centimeter cube electrolytic solution conductance will be just multiply the two. And this is our lambda EQ, means equivalent conductance. Again, unit is very important. This K must be substituted in ohm inverse centimeter inverse, and this normality in gram equivalent per liter. And that is why in this manner lambda EQ unit will come as ohm inverse centimeter square equivalent inverse. My point is clear. We have defined here molar conductance, we have defined here equivalent conductance. We have got the relation between molar conductance and conductivity K. We have got the relationship between equivalent conductance and conductivity K. Now we will try to find the relation between molar conductance and equivalent conductance. Relation between lambda m and lambda eq, molar conductance and equivalent conductance. We have set lambda m as 1000 k by m and lambda eq as 1000 k by n. If I divide the two, then lambda m upon lambda eq can be written as 1000k will get cancelled and it will be n upon m. N is the normality and m is the molarity of the same electrolytic solution, and we know normality is equal to molarity into n factor. So this is what n factor. This way, lambda m comes equal to lambda eq into n factor, where n factor we have already defined earlier. N factor in case of acid is the number of replaceable H plus. For example, H2SO4, the N factor is 2. And for base, it is number of replaceable OH minus. For example, any OH, 1 OH minus replaceable, that is why N factor is 1. And salt, for salt, it is the number of positive or negative charges. For example, ZnSO4, you can see Zn2 plus and SO4 2 minus. That is why N factor for this ZnSO4 will be 2. And in case of oxidizing and reducing agents, there N factor is number of electrons transferred, number of moles of electrons lost or gained per mole of the substance, Okay, and N factor here is also defined as the change in the oxidation number per mole of the substance. My point is clear. Dear students, to understand the concept of molar conductance and equivalent conductance in a better manner, I will discuss questions based on these concepts in the next video session. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.